Ooh, I've got a bad feeling about this. Attack!
Taking aim! Don't go near Sheriff Rookie's jail. It's been run over with Cunnel Trow. You've come looking for my Bogan, haven't you?
Of course you have. But it's gone he is, for he's the one, the chosen one, who free the fair princess from cruel bondage. And what do ye suppose that means to a poor old woman like me? Why, everything, that's what. For he's promised to come back, my Ogun, and take me away from this awful place and give me a proper house with glass in the windows, floors of wood, and a larder so full we'll never know hunger again. So, when you see him, tell him his mother loves him.
Pardon me. Watch out for Sheriff.
Hello, traveller. Could I interest you in any of my finely crafted barrels? I have many models to choose from, all displayed attractively right outside my shop.
Let me think. Now.
Welcome to the Kirk of Houghton, young man. We can lay our hands for a healing and blessing, should you feel inclined to make a small donation.
Here you are.
Blessings upon you.
Sorry.
I believe you may have killed the wrong chicken.
How tough can it be? It's a chicken! I'll eat like a king for weeks. Charge!
Attack!
Pardon me.
What are you doing? Stop that right now. Why are you breaking my barrels?
Sorry, but breaking barrels is one of my hobbies.
Well, I can't have you breaking those barrels. I haven't sold them yet. I could, however, offer you some incentive to practice your hobby elsewhere.
Incentive? Now you're speaking my language. What do you have in mind?
The more broken barrels in the world, the more people need to buy my new ones. You just practice your hobby, and I'll pay you a bounty for every barrel you break.
Sounds too easy. What's the catch?
No catch. Just keep smashing barrels and I'll start setting aside silver for you for every new barrel I sell to replace the ones you've broken. Come back here any time and I'll make good on my promise.
Well, I don't know if I trust you, but since I plan on smashing barrels anyways, it doesn't matter now, does it? You got a deal.
So you're the fellow what's been chasing through Houghton with your rats and lightning spiders, eh?
Don't worry, Sheriff. They don't bite. Much.
Now, there's no cause to be trying that attitude with me. I'm for collecting the taxes and keeping the peace. I have enough problems with the Cunnel Tra around here. I don't need to be worrying about the likes of you.
Well now, you must be the bard that everyone's been talking about, the fellow with the spider made of lightning. It's honoured I am to have you in my shop, sir, and happy to facilitate all your arms and armament needs. Swords, bows or armour, everything here is first rate and for sale. Terms of cash in advance, in full, all sales final, with no letters of credit, layaways or IOUs. We do have a buyback policy, if you buy it, don't bring it back, haha. So look over what you want and I'll be happy to cover the finer points of any item I have in stock, but remember the golden rule, you break it, you buy it.
Show me your armor.
It's a fact. A warrior's only as tough as his weakest armor. Plenty of folks have bought the cheap stuff, but none of them have been repeat customers, if you take my meaning.
What else you got? I could use a new melee weapon.
This is where we have our close combat weaponry. When you're battling a foe up close and personal, you don't want to skimp on your instrument of battle. In most cases, not the best man, but the best weapon walks away to tell the tale.
Worth my time. Show me your bows.
If you ask me, there's no better place to battle a deadly foe than from a distance. The more you spend on this ranged weaponry will not only put you further from your enemy, but also further from your own tombstone.
Let me see something else.
Heard it already.
You're really not very good at this, are you? Oh, well, here's your cut.
Welcome back. What can I do for you?
I'd like to see your bows.
If you ask me, there's no better place to battle a deadly foe than from a distance. The more you spend on this ranged weaponry will not only put you further from your enemy, but also further from your own tombstone.
Will you tell me about this?
You're looking to drop them from a distance? That's a longbow. These are the finest kiln-dried white-ash bows from the weapon shops of Kirkwall, the choice of Sylvan assassins and until recently banned in four provinces. Poles preset to £50 and guaranteed to put a 4-ounce shaft through a 2-inch plank from 50 paces. Believe me, these babies pack a punch that your enemies will not forget, and they're definitely worth every last bit of silver that I'm asking. Excellent choice, my friend, for the longbow is often the key to a long life. Use it in good health.
Well now, fancy running into you again?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I'm sure it's all a big coincidence.
I see you picked up some more magic along the way. If it's even more power you'd like, then you ought to pay a visit to my brother, Boov. In Kirkwall.
Your brother, eh? He anything like you?
Oh, no. He's not really my brother, you see. But a member of my order.
Of course he is.
Now, lad, you've only benefited from the knowledge I've given you in the past.
That's what worries me.
Seek out Boov in Kirkwall. I'll speak no more of it. Good luck to you, laddie.
Charge!
Hang you for a meddling fool! It's one thing to be frightening the widows and killing the rats, but you've up and set loose that pig-stealing, backstabbing cattle swart!
Well, laddie, he's taken to hiding in the Neversdale Forest, and you're the one that's going after him.
So you just head out of town and bring him to me! But don't come back here without him! I told you to bring me kettle! Now get off your arse and get after him!
Welcome back. What can I do for you?
What have you got in the way of shields and armor?
It's a fact. A warrior's only as tough as his weakest armor. Plenty of folks have bought the cheap stuff, but none of them have been repeat customers, if you take my meaning.
Well, interesting.
Now you're talking leather armor. Reinforced with hammer-forged iron studding and all-weather bronze buckles cast by the sea folk of the western shores. Like all my leathers, it's fully articulated for comfort and ease of movement and will keep you standing when others leave you bleeding. So it's well worth my one-time profit-shaving price. A smart man, Yarn, one who knows the true value of his own life. I've always said there's no reason to try and save money when it comes to armor, for you can't take it with you.
Show me your swords and flails.
This is where we have our close combat weaponry. When you're battling a foe up close and personal, you don't want to skimp on your instrument of battle. In most cases, not the best man, but the best weapon walks away to tell the tale.
Let me see something else. Interesting.
Peeking at my map, are you? I can tell you this much. It's as old as the hills and chock full of danger and delight. The fellow I had it from said there's plenty of frights to make things hot, plenty of X's marking the spot.
Let me see something else.
Next.
Thank you.
Come and get me, you meandering moron!
Ketil, quit cowering up there like the frightened rodent that you are. Come out and fight!
Ah, your mother's a firbolg and your old man's a trow!
You don't want to make me come up there.
Save your singing for the sheep, you crooning coward! No more! No more! Don't kill me! I was only kidding about your sister. I'll come with you.
Put your hands behind your back.
Now what? You won't be trying any of them perversions, will you?
I'm making sure you can't run away again. Or, if you prefer, I could just cut you off at the knees.
But you're the one who let me go! And now you're taking me back? Are you bored out of your skull or just wrong in the head? Ow! Stop hitting me!
Would you prefer I start stabbing you? Now shut your mouth and come with me.
With Ketil in tow, the bard moved on, hoping to avoid the trial and bring his prisoner back to Houghton.
Welcome to Pisky's magical battermaid transport thingy to the future! Oh.
Excuse me?
I don't smell anything. Wait! You're the barf, right? My brother told me about you. What did he say? Oh, yeah. He said the barf. Hey, Ketil, what are you doing here? You know, Fnarf is looking for you. Fnarf rhymes with barf. I can make up a song about you, too.
Listen, I don't have time for your ramblings. Perhaps you could just take me across the river.
Taking the barf across the river. That was it. And, now, what was the special barf deal?
Seeing as I'm in a bit of a hurry, and you're not in much condition to sail, why don't I just take that ferry across on my own?
Oh, can't do that. Too dangerous the Pisky River is for the novice. How much did my brother pay or charge you?
10 silver, I think.
Give him a bit of a ribbon, did you?
Maybe.
Oh, good. He's too upright anyway. I'll take you over for the same price.
Ready to shoot on across the Pisky River?
Let's get going.
Keep your arms and your legs. Let's get this rowed on the ship. You know, as the captain of this ship, I can legally marry you two if you want. Now be careful as you get out. Because the dock is made out of hickory wood, and it can get slick if it's wet. Which makes it a very slippery hickory dock.
Well now, what have we here? I don't know you, but Ketil, my clandestine companion, when was the last time we saw each other?
Well now, let's see. I was on my way to Houghton and...
Oh wait, I remember. Yes, it was when you pilfered my prized possession, my exquisite eagle charm.
It wasn't me, Fnarf. It was this beggar right here who stole it. I was bringing him back to you when he knocked me over the head, took it from me person, and tied me up.
Hold on a minute. I never saw this thing before in my life. I found it in Ketil's house when I came to take him back to Houghton.
The perplexing problem is, if I were to let you go, my feral friends here would consider me a coward. You see, they might even get into their noggins the notion that they could take over this bloodthirsty band. So, we're going to bash your brains and purloin your property. Nothing personal, you understand.
If there's one thing I hate, it's Kunal Trow with delusions of grandeur.
Quick! Cut me loose so I can fight!
All right, Ketil, but don't betray my trust. Attack!
Stay down! Give my regards to the sheriff, you simpleton.
Kettle, of course, took the opportunity to run away.
To go see a guy about a gelding. So, I'll suffer you to survive for now. When we assemble again, you won't find yourself as fortunate.
Despite the bard's warm and shining personality, people continue to run from him like the plague. Perhaps he would one day learn that in order to keep friends near, a man such as himself needed to keep them tied up.
If only I could find a sock big enough to put in that mouth of yours.
Though Fnarf had escaped, the bard had the unmistakable feeling that they would meet again.
Of course, that's how these things always work. If they just stayed around and took their beating like a man for the first time, they'd save me a lot of trouble. You can run, Kettle, but you can't hide.
You'd never have found me if it weren't for that mangy dog.
Mangy? Well, there's the pot calling the kettle black. Or kettle calling the pot black. Forget it. Just start walking.
Just you wait. My brother Shaw will hear about this. Then you're going to get it. You'll see. He doesn't like people picking on his kid brother. Oh, no, sir.
Shut your gob and stand downwind. You're making my dog sick.
So, you swine, happy to see me? Just you try running again, and it's fodder for the fin folk you'll be.
Now, about my reward.
Reward? You're lucky I don't throw you in jail.
So, no reward then?
Out with you!
Sorry. Pardon me.
Welcome to Chubnik's Magical Waterway Transportation Service to the future.
Are you serious?
Not the first time I've been asked that question. Yes, you heard right. Chubnik's Magical Waterway Transportation Service will, for a modest fee, whisk you not just across the raging Chubnik River, but also transport you into the future.
How far into the future?
That depends on how long it takes to cross the river.
Oh, I get it. Nice scam. So you're going to take me across that little stream for some ridiculous fee when I could quite easily take your boat and cross myself, right?
A wise man you are, that is for sure. But wrong you'd also be. I, of course, have taken magical precautions against such an occurrence. Any attempt by someone other than myself to use this boat, and it will sink into the river. Not until it reaches the deepest portion, of course. Only the tiniest fee is required to garner my services. 15 silver.
15, eh? I don't know. That sounds a little high. Since you seem to love the river so much, perhaps you'd care for a little swim?
I see. It's obviously your first visit to Neversdale, and as a first-time visitor, I may be able to give you a small discount. Now, don't tell your friends. This is a special deal only for you. 10 silver.
Ah, that sounds more reasonable. I'm tired of listening to my own wet boots stomp through the forest anyway.
Ready to board?
Let's get going.
They'll keep your arms and legs inside the vessel at all times. You aren't pregnant, are you? No, of course you're not. The raging Chumnik River and surrounding Chumnik Valley contain over 1,000 types of flora and fauna. Let me point out a few. Oh, be careful as you disembark. And thank you for choosing Chumnik's Magical Waterway Transportation Service. We know that you have a choice in your waterway transportation services, and we value your patronage.
Prepare to die. I am Organ, the Chosen One. Nothing will stop me from my quest to save the princess and drive the evil from this land. Have at you!
And what have we here? Another Chosen One? Off to save the princess?
Brave talk for someone who picks on craved half-wits with more bravery than sense. I assure you that you will soon join him. Charge!
Taking aim.
Stay down!
Taking aim.
Daft young fool. What was he on about? Some sort of princess he was going to rescue? Chosen one. He must have been out of his mind.
The bard, of course, was overcome with sympathy for the poor, deceased young man.
By the way, your mum says hello.
With a great deal of skill, or perhaps a tremendous amount of luck, the bard disposed of the murderous trowel. With a bit more luck, he might even come out the other end of the forest without an arrow coming out the other end of his head.
Always the optimist.
Oh, it's bad luck to be you. A chosen one of many isn't you. When you think you're full of luck,
in the port you'll get struck.
Oh, it's bad luck to be you. Now Ogin came young from the farm, and trying to save the princess from all harm. Equipped with just a stick and a head made out of brick, his rabbit's foot failed as a charm. Oh, it's bad luck to be you. Prophecy is never coming true. In the pickle you'll be stuck.
Like a chicken you will cluck.
Oh, it's bad luck to be you. Believing that he was the one, his ego weighed in at a ton.
His mom's a crazy bat.
Did we mention she was fat?
And she'll need a pine box for her son.
Oh, it's bad luck to be you. Don't think for just a second it's not true.
When your life is run amok,
you will see that you're the schmuck.
Oh, it's bad luck to be, really bad luck to be. Nobody could disagree. It's a freaking guarantee. It's bad luck to be you. It'll lead to...
I've got some bad news, I'm afraid. Your boy was slain. Murdered by a Trow.
Oh, no! Tell me it isn't true! Killed! I hope you avenged my boy.
I'm sorry to have to be the one to tell you, but I want you to know, the ones that killed him, I cut them down where they stood.
You avenged my Organ. Thank you, thank you. I knew you were a good man. May your future journeys continue in good health. Here, this was a charm Organ gave me, said it'd bring me luck. Why don't you take it?
Welcome back. What can I do for you?
What have you got to stab and bash with?
This is where we have our close combat weaponry. When you're battling a foe up close and personal, you don't want to skimp on your instrument of battle. In most cases, not the best man, but the best weapon walks away to tell the tale.
Can you tell me about this?
Like to do some fancy dual weapon fighting, then you've got to have a dirk. This one comes straight from Finstown and features a fully fuller ricasso and ring guard for precise blade control. A thrust through the visor or chink in the armor and I guarantee your man is going down. Now that kind of weapon doesn't come cheap, but I'd be happy to sell you this particular item for a first-rate price. Very good find, sir. I'm not a fighting man, but having an extra weapon to stick in your foes can never be a bad thing, can it?
What have you got to stab and bash with?
This is where we have our close combat weaponry. When you're battling a foe up close and personal, you don't want to skimp on your instrument of battle. In most cases, not the best man, but the best weapon walks away to tell the tale.
Let me see something else.